Good evening, and Merry Christmas from the Joneses. Please come worship with us at Missoula's First Presbyterian Church.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Merry Christmas, and God bless from the Joneses.
Merry Christmas, love the Addams Family.
Hi, I'm Bob Davis. This is my wife, Char.
Hi, everybody.
We're new to First Presbyterian Church. We're very, very happy to be joining the congregation. And we did want to point out our Christmas tree here. We got it from Troop 1115 in Florence, Boy Scout Troop. And we used to work the tree lot. In fact, that's how we met, was working the tree lot for Troop 235, Boy Scout Troop. In any event, we're very, very happy to come, and everybody at First Presbyterian Church has been very, very nice. And we would also like to point out, this is what we look like without a mask and without a grizzly in between us. So we want to wish you a Merry Christmas, and we're hoping to meet you all soon.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Mele Kalikimaka. Welcome to worship at First Presbyterian Church.
Merry Christmas from the Coulter family.
Welcome to the service.
And Merry Christmas from the Rubies.
Merry Christmas.
And Happy New Year.
From the Armstrongs.
Merry Christmas. And welcome to worship with First Presbyterian Church.
Merry Christmas to all and to all good night.
Happy Christmas everyone.
From our house to your house.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
A reading from Isaiah 9.
The people who sat in darkness have seen a great light.
For those who lived in a land of deep shadows, light, sunburst of light.
You enlarged the nation and increased their joy.
Oh, they're so glad in your presence. Festival joy.
The joy of great celebration, sharing rich gifts and warm greetings.
For a child has been born for us, the gift of a son for us.
He'll take over the running of the world. His names will be
Wonderful Counselor,
Mighty God,
Everlasting Father,
Prince of Peace.
Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end.
He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom,
establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness.
From that time on and forever.
Tonight we celebrate the coming of a great light to people living in deep darkness. The good news of God's majesty and mercy, born to all who wait in exile with expectant hope. Welcome to Christmas Eve worship with our church family, wherever and in whatever circumstances you may find yourselves this Christmas Eve, whether that may be at home or in a place that feels far from home. I'm Dan Cravey, and I'm honored to serve as pastor of this congregation. And in a year of such grief and isolation and fatigue, in a year of such hunger for divine life and light, I'm so grateful to gather under the same bright star that sparkled over the sky of Bethlehem. So grateful to come with you, whom I love, to behold the mystery of our hope lying in a manger. You know that it's our tradition to light candles together today as we sing Silent Night. And so we'll light our candles across the city, across the country, across the world, in fact. It's also been our joy to celebrate Christ's birth with an act of self-giving love. And so we'll invite an offering later to provide shelter and financial assistance to homeless families and to persons in crisis. We encourage you to make a Christmas Eve gift that will go fully to FPC's Helping Hands Ministry, by sending a check to the church or or going online and designating that for Helping Hands. And so now let us attend, my friends, to the good news that we are not forgotten. That our Lord Jesus Christ comes to us wherever we're held captive to set us free. Let's pray. Gracious God, on this holy night, we give you thanks for closing the distance between heaven and earth, for piercing our hearts with the mystery of your love, for lifting up the poor, for binding up the brokenhearted, for bearing hope to the hopeless. On this night, we celebrate the good news of your word made flesh, of your coming with majestic strength and merciful tenderness, of your present power to break our captivity to the dark. On this holy night, gathered by your Spirit, we bend our knees and lift our hearts to you, rejoicing at the birth of the one who has humbled himself to dwell among us, Emmanuel, God with us, Jesus, the Messiah of Israel, and the world's true Lord. Amen.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them.
Tonight is the night we have all been waiting for. Our Advent wreath will be completed by the lighting of our Christ candle. We light the candle of hope as we await the coming of Jesus, who is our source of hope. We light the candle of peace, knowing that Jesus is the Prince of Peace. We light the candle of joy, knowing that our comfort and help come from God. We light the candle of love, knowing that God is love revealed to us in Jesus Christ. And we light the Christ candle, knowing that Christ is truly the center of our lives. With the birth of Jesus, our lives will be forever changed. We will be transformed by his model and his message.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies, with angelic hosts
and imagined a savior. We imagined power, one like the world, but stronger and on our side. We imagined a king on a white horse wielding a sword. Instead, we got a baby born in a stable among the livestock. We imagined the work done for us through the destruction of our enemies. We received a baby who will teach us our calling to seek reconciliation and to love expansively. Praise be to God for the unexpected babe of Bethlehem. Praise to the wisdom of love.
There's a small framed picture in the place where I pray. It's a print of a broad-shouldered man. He's facing away and his back is to us. And the man's wearing full plate armor. He looks like a medieval knight, and the armor is up to his neck, but there is no helmet. And in his arms, a small child looks over his shoulder at us. The child leans against the warrior's cheek and rests a tiny hand on the armored shoulder. This is an image of muscular power and gentle affection, a picture of strength and tenderness. One of my mentors gave me this print on the day that I was ordained to serve in pastoral ministry. It's an image to recall just who God is when I forget or when I feel forgotten. An image to surprise me again and again with the good news that we celebrate on Christmas Eve. As a church family, we've been meditating on Isaiah 40 for the season of Advent. And the prophecy of this passage anticipates not only the coming of God to forgive and to free his people from captivity in a foreign land far away, it anticipates the surprising joy of how this God will come to comfort all people who feel forgotten in the darkness of their suffering. Listen then, my friends, on this Christmas Eve for the good news from Isaiah 40. Listen for both the strength and the tenderness of the God who comes to us in our exile, wherever we are. Comfort, O comfort, my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, "In the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the uneven places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken." A voice says, "Cry out." And I said, "What shall I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like a flower of the field. The grass withers and the flower fades where the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass." The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings and good news. Lift it up, do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, "Here is your God." See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep. Brothers and sisters, this is the word of the Lord. Let us all say, thanks be to God. To the people in exile, isolation, captivity, fear, and grief. To the people who feel forgotten in the darkness of their suffering, comes God's comfort. There is good news to proclaim. Get you up to a high mountain, Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. God is commissioning Isaiah to go tell it on the mountain. And the substance of what he has to proclaim is so very significant because it's the first use of the term gospel in the Old Testament. Linking all that God does to forgive and free the captives to the coming of Christ. Lift up your voice. Do not fear. Deliver God's message to those who sit in darkness and the shadow of death. There is soul freeing, heart healing, society transforming, good news to proclaim. And what's that good news? What's the gospel that Isaiah has to announce? It's both simple and world upending. Here is your God. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. The good news is God's presence and power come to a place where God seemed invisible and absent. So I have a question for you. Have you known a place where God seemed invisible and absent in 2020? Have you felt forgotten in the fatigue of it all? I learned this week that, unsurprisingly, the Merriam-Webster word of the year is pandemic. And we may forever return to that word as a word that reminds us of just how fragile we really are. But some of the words that are runners-up to the word of the year also speak to the emotional and the spiritual toll of this strange season. Social distancing, face mask, lockdown, unprecedented, hellacious, and apocalyptic, which is actually a word that means to the revelation of God in a time of great unrest. Throw in way too many hours on Zoom, you know, saying, can you hear me? Can you see me? And throw in the tiger training that we've become accustomed to calling distance learning. And throw in the warranted social unrest over racial injustice and a painfully polarizing presidential election. And then there's little doubt that, like Israel in captivity, we've all of us been waiting for good news, watching in weariness, it seems to me, for something more powerful than a presidential pick and more healing than a vaccine. Isaiah announces good news to those weary with waiting in the year 2020. Here is your God, present, right here, right now, in the place where God seemed invisible and absent. Do you notice the imagery proclaiming who God will be for us? The Lord God will come with might. God is strong to save, a conquering warrior of great power, a knight in steely armor, capable to free us from the oppressive forces that imprison us. And the Lord God comes with tenderness. God will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them mother-like in his bosom, close to his heart. God is gentle to tend and to guide us. Here is your God, both mighty and merciful, a strong shepherd, a nurturing knight, not only capable in power, but compassionate to care for you and me. This is who God is, and who God will be. Good news for a weary world. And today, we celebrate not only who God is, but the joyful surprise of how God comes to us. Here is your God, my friends. You are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sin. Here is your God. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. Here is your God. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. Here is your God. The Word became flesh and dwelled among us, and we have seen his glory, full of grace and truth. Here is your God, coming to you in human weakness, strong to save you from your suffering, tender to carry you close to his heart. The good news we celebrate on Christmas Eve is that in the birth of Jesus, God is with us. In this fallen world, we're not forgotten. To trust in his mysterious presence is a transforming comfort, both mighty and merciful. Will he be born afresh in you tonight? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
On this silent night, Christ came into the world, piercing the darkness with hope. Christ is the light of all lights. We associate candles with Advent and Christmas. Glowing candles are twinkling and radiant in our homes. In our churches, we see the Advent candles of hope, peace, joy, and love. Wherever we see them, candles may be a silent witness to that glorious light of Bethlehem. Together as a community of God's people, wherever we may be, we bring the light of each to become the light of all. Together, we share the light of Christ, lifting the darkness of doubt, despair, or fear that covers the world. That is such a light that the world cannot extinguish. So let us all light our candles as we sing Silent Night, knowing that the light of the world has come to us.
Oh.
The special offering for this Christmas Eve will be our Helping Hands ministry. Through this ministry, First Presbyterian Church is able to assist families in need in our community. We coordinate our efforts with the YWCA and other faith communities, and we do this to identify places where our gifts can do the most good. The gifts are mostly funded through special offerings. With Helping Hands, our church provides help for emergency needs such as rental and deposit fees, power bills, phone bills, groceries, interim housing, car repairs, and much more. In 2020, this assistance by our church has been provided to 68 families, including 125 children. This week, we visited a young mom with three children. She comes from a background of abuse and addiction. In meeting and getting to know her, we have been so impressed with her drive to become the mom that she never had for her children. And she told me about a vision that she has, a vision of a mom her kids can rely on, to be there for them, to provide for them, and to love them. And she is being that mom here in Missoula with help from her tribe, the YWCA, and our congregations. This week, Helping Hands was able to give her a few gift cards from our giving tree so that she could get Christmas gifts for her children, and she was overjoyed. This Christmas Eve, the special offering will be for the Helping Hands ministry, and if you'd like to help, please make your check to FPC and indicate Helping Hands on the memo line, or you can go to the church website and give online. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. Matthew 25, verse 35.
Let us join our hearts in prayer. Good and gracious God, we come to your manger, each of us, in the stillness of this night. Here we know our profound powerlessness in a year when the darkness has felt overwhelming and so disorienting. And here we find you, a vulnerable, powerless newborn, yet the infant child in whom we discover the ruler of the universe who becomes our rescuer. On this holiest of nights, we join the everlasting chorus saying, "Glory to God in the highest. Great is your name in all the earth." Like Mary, we ponder these things in our hearts, and we wonder how you could love us so much as to actually become one of us, one with us. We remember your birth story that reminds us of your steadfast love and affirms that you have never and will never give up on your children. Thank you for your steadfast presence in our lives. And yet, even on this night in which we celebrate the fulfillment of love, we recognize that there are many who are still waiting for fulfillment. The fulfillment of adequate food and shelter, the fulfillment of peace and the end of division, the fulfillment of release from the fierce grip of grief, the fulfillment of a restoration of a broken relationship, the fulfillment of a renewing of heart, mind, or body, the fulfillment of an end to addiction, the fulfillment of healing from a disease or despair. Giving God, who gave us your very self, give us the courage to trust your work in our lives to bring fullness and wholeness. Give us courage to share your steadfast love with our hurting world, and strengthen us to share the peace coming to us in the manger this evening. God, who chose vulnerability, born in the night, meet us as a newborn child meets new parents, come to change our lives forever. Meet us as the infant who insists that we make room for you, who requires that we reorder our lives to pay attention to you, who demands that we be recentered on you, the very center of life. Tender God, come close. Meet us here in the places we need you the most, that we may know your awesome power as the light that shines in the darkness, your light that the darkness cannot extinguish. God of strength and steadfastness, we stretch our hearts to make room for you within. Be born anew in our homes and hearts this night. Be born in our broken world, desperate for your hope and healing. Be born afresh in our lives. We ask this in the name of the Christ child. Amen.
The Lord is come, let earth receive.
Zechariah sings of the birth of Jesus as joy to the world. By the tender mercy of our God, the dawn from on high will break upon us to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the paths of peace. Brothers and sisters, wherever you are, let us welcome the Lord of strength and tenderness, who does not forget us, who refuses to be God without us, who sets the captives free today and tomorrow and tomorrow. Would you stand and sing with me? Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Christ the Lord. Merry Christmas.